Hello? Oh, wow, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to startle you. I heard you weeping, so I thought perhaps I could be of some assistance.
No, I'm okay.
But you're sitting here and you're crying and...
I said I'm okay.
Okay, I don't mean to pry. Do you mind if I sit here next to you on my bench, on this bench?
I do mind. You know, social distancing. Where's my mask?
You know, that happens sometimes. It's not a good thing. Forgetting your mask. Oh, where's my mask, by the way? I know I didn't leave home without it. But thank God I got tested today and I got my results back in 3 hours. I'm negative.
Yeah, and I did the same.
And?
Negative!
You do know that testing negative is a positive thing. Well, great then. I guess I'll just sit over here next to you on the bench, way over here where it's safe. And think of Bethlehem. Well, don't cry. It's Christmas time. Besides, in this weather, your tears will freeze up like icicles. Okay, all right. Wait, I have something. All right. All right. I got something for you here. I have some tissues. Please, here, help yourself. Come on, your nose is running. Go.
Thanks.
Whoa. Are you sure you tested negative?
Yes. And my nose runs when I cry like everybody else's.
I'm just kidding. You know, it's funny. That's one of the things that we all have in common, a runny nose when we weep. No discrimination there. That's nice luggage. Where are you off to?
I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. Oh, you poor dear. I hope it isn't Christmas that's making you so blue.
No!
So it's probably this dreadful pandemic. You know, it's got us all a little agitated.
It's FaceTime or Zoom, constant fussing, him losing his job. The economy is taking it, and I just...
False prophets chanting and ranting and a bunch of pathological liars. They got us all confused. Okay. Here. Have another, please. Do you have enough?
Yes! I couldn't take him anymore. Constant arguing with me because he didn't like the results of the election.
Age-old United States of America feud. So, do you know where you're running to?
I don't know. I just wish the bus would hurry up and come.
Oh, that's a pretty bold move, young lady. Especially during a pandemic and it's Christmas time.
Do you always talk like this?
Oh, come now. You know, there's always going to be worldly issues. But we can't allow the adversary who's the author of confusion to divide us from our family.
What?
Yeah, God knows I know the deal. Because everyone I loved left me.
Like, really? Your whole family?
Whole family. My wife, my kids, even my dog Fluffy.
Well, I've never heard of anything like that.
You know, me either. Then I lost my job. I went into a depression. And I started running away from myself. And that is when I lost my home.
What do you mean, running away from yourself?
Well, instead of handling my problems, I started drinking. I stopped paying bills. You know, sometimes we think it's easier to run from what needs immediate attention.
Well, I can understand that.
What's worse is that I blamed it on my wife, my kids, and my job.
And your dog, Fluffy, too?
And Fluffy, too.
Well, I wonder how your children feel without you being around.
Well, I suspect that they felt abandoned. Or maybe they were relieved because of the way I was acting back then. But you know what? Now we're reunited. And I thank God for his mercy for allowing them to forgive me.
Forgave you? Well, but they left you.
No, who they left was an immature and selfish man that was lost, that was supposed to be the head of his household and a good partner for my wife.
I've been accused of being immature and selfish too.
Yeah, but it's not worth ending up homeless though.
So you were really homeless, like living in the streets?
Man, oh yeah. Yep, called all kinds of names. Bum, derelict, vagabond. Right on this very bench. I came here this evening to remind myself of where I was. You know, I learned a lot on this bench.
Like what?
Well, I learned about people. I learned about people who care and people that will just turn away. I learned about harsh weather. I learned how to appreciate any meal and how to share that meal with others. But mostly, I guess, I learned about myself.
Boy, I never thought about being homeless. It sounds really scary.
Yeah, it is, especially on these streets. But you know what was ironic? The people were afraid of me because I had a cup in my hand. A cup for loose change and not a gun.
Where's the bus?
What is your name?
Mercedes. Yours?
Well, everyone calls me Marty.
It's so Marty. How did you get yourself together?
Well, my mother. In jail.
What? Your mama was in jail?
Well, yes and no. I actually had a dream about her. You know, it happened the very night that I was arrested. Now, they said that I was disturbing the peace. I guess I was, in a way. See, there was this storm brewing. And I'm telling you, three hots and a cot for a homeless person is better than Jack Frost nipping at your open toes, if you know what I mean. Yeah, anyway. As I fell asleep in the jail cell, suddenly I saw my mom. Mother? Mom? Mom, is that you?
Yes, Marty.
Mother, it's so good to see you.
I've been watching you, son.
Oh, Mom, I've been missing you. Dad as well, but I've really been missing you. And Mom, look, I still have the Christmas stocking you gave me.
Yes, I see. And it's all tattered, just like you.
Well, Mom, I had some tough times after you and Dad, Johnny, and Sissy passed away.
Yeah, I know. And not to mention it was really hard on your wife and on the children, too.
Mom, they just left me.
Why do you think that is, Marty?
I don't know.
Come on, Marty. You know. You've always been my smartest child and a little too smart for your own good.
All right, Mom, I messed up with my wife. I tried to fix it, but I didn't know how. I told her what a good person I was. But Mom, I'm kind. Mm-hmm. I'm kind to people. I speak to everybody that I see. I don't judge, and I give good advice. You know I have 2 degrees.
2 degrees? Yep. And living on the Bowery, feeling empty deep inside your soul. And always searching, searching for something that's so easily in your reach. Your dad and I didn't raise you this way.
I know, Mom, but...
Well, if you know, what are you going to do to make a change?
Mom, the world is not like it was when I was coming up.
Of course it's not. Nothing is. Have you been reading your Bible? It's all in there.
No. But I've been reading the newspapers. And Mom, I'm telling you, what's been going on today is depressing. It's nonsensical.
Marty, what's nonsensical is that you can't keep doing the same old thing and expect different results. We taught you to strive to be Christ-like. But you've stopped praying. And you seem to take some sort of pride in telling folk that you're a kind man who's doing good and good to others. But in fact, you've become an intellectual unbeliever.
Mom, you gotta admit, these Christians, these evangelicals, mm-hmm. I mean, they're so mean and belligerent. Yeah. You should have seen this woman today claiming to love
but
God.
She is not my child. You are. And you've stopped believing in God.
Mom, how can I believe in God when they don't let us in the church? And the Bible says to come as you are.
But this is not who you are.
She told me we didn't raise you like that.
Your dad and I didn't raise you like this. And as for that Christmas stocking I left you.
I know, Mom, it's tattered.
Yeah, you anxiously took all the goodies out. But you didn't reach down far enough.
What?
You need to reach into the soul of it.
She said that I didn't reach far enough.
See, Marty, you're always searching, but you're not reaching. So reach your hand into the soul of that Christmas stocking. Start there, son. Reach. Reach. Reach your hand into the soul of it. Start there. Start there, son. Start there.
Mother, Mom. Reach your hand into the soul of the stocking. Reach your hand into the... Reach your hand. My dear son, always remember, for unto us a child is given, a child is born, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. The government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Wow. So that's what made you change?
Yeah. And because of my mother's advice, I went right to church and I pray for forgiveness. You know, I had been running from God's will for my life for many years and also pushing away people that disagree with me. So I come here to this very bench every Christmas Eve, look at the stars and reflect on, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever believes in him shall not perish,
but have everlasting life. Yeah.
Oh, so you know the scriptures?
Yes. Yes, I do. But with people who say they love God and represent God and then defend liars and killers, I'm not even sure there is God.
I completely understand.
You do?
Yeah.
Because I don't feel like anybody understands me.
You know, it's just like you in a way. But I had to learn not to allow the failures of some Christians change my faith.
Even if it's my dad, I don't understand him. He's still upset about the election. Can't he see that we need a change?
You know, it's okay to disagree, as long as it's in love. And as long as you realize that God is in control. His word says that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord
and are called according to his purpose.
You got it.
You really believe that all things work together for good?
Yes, I do.
I mean, I see people actually trying to normalize corruption in any form, and many of them are so-called Christians. I don't know why he can't see that.
Yeah, so-called Christians. They seem to be more wrapped up in their politics and propaganda and their false prophecy and not the word of God. You know, even though I have 2 degrees, I was homeless running from that word. But look at me now. I'm filled with love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, and
gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control, which I don't have much of these days. You know, I don't even know if I'll ever have a degree because I can't afford one.
But it doesn't mean a thing to have that degree if you're empty inside. My degrees didn't bring my family back. That took a work of God. And now I'm working in the homeless shelters. I'm helping people get back up on their feet. And God is using me and my degrees now to help other people. Don't lose faith in God's word, Mercedes.
Yeah, well, it's getting really cold out here. Where's the bus, man?
Mercedes. Mercedes. The Bible says that all authority comes from God. And people in positions of authority are put there by God. So, if God is God, and he is, and if God is in control, and he is, then there is a season and a reason for this new administration.
You know what, Marty?
Yes.
That actually makes sense.
You know, we can't allow things to tear our families and our relationships apart. We need a movement of God, and God is moving, and something is happening. Something glorious is happening.
Here comes the bus.
Oh, okay. Well, let me help you with your bags.
No, I'm going home. Thanks, Marty. Merry Christmas to you and your family. Oh, and your dog Fluffy, too.
Merry Christmas to you, too, Mercedes. And oh, look what I found. My mask.
Jesus is our only hope. Thanks, Marty.
All things have led us to this day. Creation has prepared a way. Her wait is done. The chosen one, our King has come, the earth, the sun. A roaring lion from the wild, with it a lamb tender and mild. He has arrived, he will revive. Let all who slumber come alive. Something's happening. Something in the air is
happening.
Something everywhere is
happening.
New life is happening.
Something's happening.
Something glorious is
happening.
Something more for us is happening. New life is happening.
The answer to the sinner's prayer. Something in the air is happening. Something everywhere is happening. New life is happening. Something's happening. Something glorious is happening. Something more for us is happening. New life is happening. This is a monumental space and time. Don't let it slip away and pass you by.